Do you have trouble figuring out your sensitivity? Wish your frame rate was a tad bit higher? Maybe you have a hard time seeing enemies in Valorant. Well, today I've got quite a spicy video. We're gonna cover some great settings that can help you improve your gameplay. These settings are a combination of my own personal preference as well as what I've seen many other top players use as well. However, at the end of the day, choose what you're comfortable with. Try these out, but if you don't feel like they're right for you, then feel free to revert them back. Hey guys, my name is Dan, and today I'll be your own personal guide on these techniques. I'm super excited to share with you these useful settings that can help you feel more confident and better equipped to win your Valorant games. If you guys enjoy this type of content, make sure to comment down below which setting you found most interesting or useful. Also, if you feel like we missed anything, comment below what your secret setting is. Before we dive straight in, as always, we have our question of the day. What do you guys think about the Ani skin collection? Personally, I love that we finally have an upgradable Phantom skin. It's my favorite rifle over the Vandal, and I'm glad Riot is finally showing it some love. However, I wish they did more with the sound design and reload animation, as it feels a little lackluster. I feel like they put more attention to detail with the Vandal, which I hope to see in future Phantom skins. Overall, it's a pretty solid bundle, and I hope to see more upgradable Phantoms down the road. Sensitivity can be a sensitive topic. Get it? Ha ha ha. Anyways, some people swear by low sens and others claim that high sens is the only way to go. I believe that both are correct, but sensitivity is best left at an individual level. The sensitivity that works for me, you, or another person for that matter is highly variable. How we grip our mice, use our arms can drastically differ from person to person. So the greatest tip I can give you for finding a solid sensitivity is going in game and trying it out. A rule of thumb I like to follow is you want to be able to smoothly track a still-standing target without feeling choppy. If it feels choppy, that means the sensitivity is too high for you. Ideally, you want to find a sweet spot where you can track this target smoothly, but you don't sacrifice your speed if you don't need to. For example, if I play on an extremely low sens, I might be able to track this target even better than I could on a slightly higher sens, but I would be sacrificing speed that I don't need to. I mentioned how having a sensitivity higher than what you're comfortable with can be problematic. The same thing goes for something extremely low. So try and find a sensitivity that allows you to smoothly control it without going overboard. You want to be able to have as much mouse control as possible and not completely sacrifice the speed. Another good test is to see if you can flick from one target to another comfortably. Combine these two tests at different ranges and you can easily find a sensitivity you like. Make sure once you commit to it, don't allow yourself to give up on it so easily. Like many things in life, practice makes perfect. If you still don't know what to do with your sensitivity, just make sure you stick to it. I would avoid copying anyone's exact sensitivity. You can use them as guidelines, but again, copying what works for someone else will rarely yield better results than finding your own sensitivity. Think about it like this. Do you think most of these players copied other people's sensitivities or found one and stuck to it? Okay, do you ever feel like you're not sure what you want to do on the attacker or defender side? Well, one simple fix to this is by making sure your minimap is properly positioned to show the entire map for you. This way, you can play on the opposite side of the map and still spot out information from the other side. This is especially useful when you're defending because you're able to see how your teammates are playing and it can help you react better without them communicating as much. Having good teammates that can communicate is an obvious perk, but being able to do this will help you climb the rank system in the long run. Depending on if you're doing fixed or rotating minimap, the values will be slightly different. The key is to make sure you can see as much as you can. Personally, I use 1.2 map size, 0.7 zoom, rotating map, and player centered off. If you have player centered turned on, make sure you zoom out more, as it will cut more of the map due to its centering around you. It's a simple change, but boy, does it do wonders. Without a properly sized map, you will often misread enemy aggression, rotate late, and not notice if the spike has been dropped. I can't tell you how many times I've been able to make a play purely based on the information that I've received from paying attention to the minimap. This wouldn't be possible if I left my map on default settings, as it doesn't encapsulate the whole map usually. I think this is the most practical change for anyone who's looking to make up for lack of communication, and it can help build game sense. The video settings are pretty straightforward in this game. If you want the absolute maximum amount of performance, setting everything to low or off is ideal. Make sure you have multi-rendering as long as you have a CPU with multiple cores. For a vast majority of people out there, this should remain on. Some video settings that are known as FPS drainers are detail quality, material quality, bloom, and distortion. None of the settings offer you anything except visual glare to the game and will eat away at your potential FPS. If you don't want the game to look terrible, look to turn on clarity, anti-aliasing, anisotropic filtering, and texture quality. In some rare cases, having texture quality on medium or high can actually improve the stability of your game depending on the computer specifications you're running. Test this out and see if it does anything for you. I personally have everything off except clarity, as it makes the gun models look better while still maintaining the best FPS experience possible for me. If there is one thing you take away from this video, it's this. I think every player should test out the two different colorblind settings that change the enemy's outlines. Although this is largely preference, I believe both purple and yellow are an improvement from the default red, as the highlight is stronger and more prevalent in my eyes. A lot of people feel the same way. Players like Wardell and Tenzi both use yellow enemy outlines, and I strongly believe it gives an advantage. Personally, I've dabbled with all three, and I believe yellow is the easiest to see for me. See how they feel to you, and maybe you'll prefer purple or yellow enemy outlines over the default ones. I will say that yellow seems to be the most aggressive outline of the three, and I often feel that I see people slightly earlier than they see me. This is most noticeable when an enemy is jiggle peeking me. I tend to see their shoulder much easier with yellow enemy outlines. Are you the type to get nervous when others are watching you? Maybe you feel like you're bad in clutch situations? Besides playing more and building that type of confidence, an easy way to ease your mind is by turning off the spectator count in the settings. This way you won't be distracted to look at the spectator count when you're being watched. It also helps to declutter your screen, as the spectator count offers no in-game advantage whatsoever. I'd even argue it may cause players to perform worse with it on. This largely depends on the player, as some people don't ever notice this feature. However, if you've ever felt nervous or distracted by the spectator count, make sure to turn it off, as it can start benefiting your gameplay when in clutch situations. Who doesn't love the satisfying look of blood spurting out of your enemy's head when you land that headshot? I'd be the first to admit that this feature is great visually and can be very stimulating. However, if you've noticed the trend, this guide is meant to remove the potential distractions that can inhibit you. For example, when you land a headshot with show blood on, it can be much more difficult to spot other enemies close by, as the blood can cover their head hitbox for a brief moment. Obviously, this is minor, but if you want as many advantages as possible, make sure to turn show blood off, and maybe it can better help you secure those multi-kills. Additionally, turning off corpses will remove bodies on the playing field. Instead, they will be replaced with holograms, which is specifically helpful when playing an agent like Sage. This can help you easily identify where your teammates died and can make your life much easier when you're looking for that fatty resurrection. This setting has saved me a ton of trouble and is a must if you play Sage quite a bit. Finding the right crosshair can be a never-ending journey for most, and although changing your crosshair around is not nearly as bad as changing your sensitivity, it can become a very bad habit if not properly addressed. The key to finding the right crosshair is choosing one that is easy to see in most terrain and doesn't hinder your vision when you have it locked onto an enemy. Some colors I would recommend are white, green, yellow, and blue. Can't go wrong with any of these, as they're fairly standard, non-distracting colors that get the job done. One exception would be green. If you play a lot of Viper, this crosshair can become problematic with that character, as all of her abilities are green as well. This can make it difficult to track your crosshair while in or coming out of her abilities. Personally, I mainly use a 1622 crosshair, as I feel it's a medium size and is fairly simplistic. Feel free to change around the length and the gap of the crosshair. However, I'd strongly recommend using 2 thickness. If you didn't know, using odd numbers will make your crosshair off-centered in Valorant, so keep that in mind. Additionally, stay away from settings like firing error and movement error, as they do more harm than good. Even if you're unfamiliar with the firing and movement mechanics of Valorant, having your crosshair move dynamically can be very distracting and hinder your aim. I would recommend having those off and naturally learning the firing and movement mechanics on your own time. Finally, if you feel like you lose track of your crosshair often, look to mess around with the crosshair outline values. The outline can help your eyes better see where your crosshair is located. Your crosshair should ideally be a static, simple, and easy to see crosshair. Personally, outlines are something that I used to use, but over time, as I've become a more experienced FPS player, I've noticed that an outline can be distracting at times. But I would say everyone's eyes are built differently. Want to be more comfortable planting and defusing the bomb? Maybe pressing 4 isn't your style. Well, one neat trick is to double bind your spike plant slash defuse to the same key that your use is bound to. Typically, the use key is bound to either F or E, which is an easier key to hit than 4. Additionally, in other games, planting the bomb is typically bound to the same key as the use slash interact key, so this can help FPS players from other games to build this muscle memory quicker. Ever since I've done this, I've noticed that defusing the bomb has become much easier, and it frees up my hand to put other inputs in more seamlessly. If you feel uncomfortable touching the bomb quickly and find yourself getting stuck in the animation, definitely look to make this change. I believe it can make a huge difference in those retake or clutch situations. Some of the settings in Valorant can really provide a significant advantage to those who use them properly. We wanted to cover some of the ones that we found most important and can help you better equip yourself for your games. If there are any settings you feel help, be sure to comment and tell us why. Additionally, if there's anything we missed, please let us know. We love to learn more too. That's all we have for this video. If you guys enjoyed this one, please like, comment, and subscribe. To keep up to date with those type of concepts, please make sure to hit the bell notification, which ensures that you stay up to date with our videos and ahead of the competition. If you want to learn more about anything Valorant related, head over to ProGuides.com for the best Valorant on-demand coaching. Our coaches are among the very best, and we hope that you check them out if you enjoy this video. They will help you with any of your individual Valorant needs and can bring you to the next level. And hey, if that's not your style, make sure to check out our Discord. We have a great community where you can chat, hang out, and possibly find friends to play with. Stay tuned for our future videos and keep up the grind, ProGuides fam.